जय भीम गुरुद्वारा टू एवरीवन फर्स्टली ऑन द बिहाफ ऑफ बिरसा अम्बेडकर पुणे स्टूडेंट एसोसिएशन आई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट इलाय कुमार फॉर लॉन्चिंग दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन यू आर लॉन्चिंग दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इन ए वेरी क्रूशियल टाइम इन आई थिंक इन रिसेंट पास्ट ड्यू टू सोशल मीडिया द आइडिया ऑफ व्यूइंग Darwinism as an progressive ideology rather than a race is growing but they are unorganized. This organization can play a crucial role right from organizing these ideas more vibrantly to resist the growing force of BJP within Tamil Nadu and India as large. The general perspective constructed in the minds of masses of Tamil Nadu about BJP's growth is that it is trying to eradicate AIDMK from the Tamil Nadu. But it is not true actually. BJP knows very well that they cannot gain a prominent position in Tamil Nadu until they do a lot of compromises with their ideology to fit into the narrative prevailing in Tamil Nadu. And those compromises will affect them in national politics. So, they will not try to replace AIDMK. In fact, even in Bihar, that is the major cow belt, they can't even win individually once. And their vote share is just 20%. Even that 20% vote share is not completely conscious about ideology of BJP. They vote for various reasons. And one of the reasons that I can think is representation. So they identify the communities which are getting ignored by the other parties, mobilize them and make a considerable amount of those communities into their supporter. They are applying the same approach in Tamil Nadu as well. BJP Tamil Nadu unit attempts to organize these minority Hindu communities and gives them representation and thereby tries to gain their support. For example, they organized many events for the Saurashtra community, which is very minority in Tamil Nadu. The sad reality about Tamil electoral politics is that due to the electoral pressure, both the prominent parties are allotting seats to the people, those who belongs to the majority OBC community of the particular constituency. There are few communities like Wasserman, Barbar, Boyar, etc., which could never become a majority community any day in any constituency. As a result, they were unnoticed by both the prominent parties of Tamil Nadu. BJP is targeting these communities nowadays. There is a community called Muthuayya, which had recently mobilized under a former RSS cadre. They also target communities such as Devendra Kula Velalar and Kongu Velalar. So under the fake image of replacing AIDMK as its agenda, it slowly wants to reach to game-changing position by gaining around 50% of vote share, which could actually be a game-changing number in Tamil Nadu context. I wish Student Federation of Darwinians as an organization would put a hurdle of all these kind of endeavors of BJP by sensitizing the students with Darwinian ideology and by also putting pressure on both prominent parties to give representation to the unrepresented communities. And BAPSA as an organization will show solidarity to SFD for these attempts. And apart from this, the whole national agenda, I would like to share some of my lived experience as a member of BAPSA in academic spaces. In India, like we all know, Brahminical ideologies are there. We all are getting influenced or exploited by this Brahminical ideology. But in outer society, it can be like by abusing by your caste name or by identity. But in academic spaces, Brahminism is not like abusing by your caste name. In academic spaces, people make you inferior for your identities and their identities like SC, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward class, your gender identities. So like I am member of BAPSA. So when I joined BAPSA, so I was questioned like why did I join BAPSA? Because BAPSA is an organization who work for Bahujan people, SC, ST, OBC, minorities, religious minorities, language minorities, gender minorities. So when we assert by our own identity, when I say I am Dalit and I proudly say I am Dalit, so they get inferiority when I assert. That is their problem. So they always question on our politics. They question us, you are doing identity politics. My whole life, my old lived experiences are just limited to my identity, and when I start accepting on my identity, you say I am doing identity politics. You say I am doing something that is related to my identity. You decided everything for me by my identity, but when I started asserting for my rights, so you feel uncomfortable. So this is hypocrisy. And as Eli Kumar explained about this Dravidian movement, so he explained what is Dravidian. So he said like Dravidian, Bahujan or Mool Nivasi, all are same. So yes, it is same. But like I am from JNU. When I came to JNU, before coming to JNU, I thought like it is a progressive space. I will see like there will be a celebration of Bahujan icons, Bahujan festivals. But when I came to JNU, it is all about Brahminical festivals. That was not Ambedkar's idea. That was not Periyar's idea. That was not Phule's idea. So still, there can be many progressive organizations in JNU, but they are not, till today, they are not celebrating Bahujan icons, Bahujan festivals. So, we, BAPSA and SFD, we all will create a campus that will celebrate our own festivals. We will not create a campus that will celebrate Brahminical festivals. If they want to celebrate, they can celebrate. But we will build a pressure in all the Indian universities where we will have our own Dravidian culture, our own Bahujan culture, not the Brahminical culture. Thank you very much. Thank you.